The battle over voting rights in Texas isn't over yet. Late Sunday night, Democratic legislators won a small but temporary victory, blocking Republicans' sweeping elections bill by walking out ahead of the vote in the final hours of the legislative session. But the Republican governor there, Greg Abbott, is determined. He says the bill would be added to a special session of the legislature, so the fight continues. This measure includes a ban on drive-through voting, new restrictions on mail-in ballots, changes to early voting hours, and it lowers the threshold for challenging election results. It's a major change in Texas's election law. And joining us now to discuss this, Mimi Marzianni, president of the Texas Civil Rights Project. Mimi, thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
So you were just talking of kind of a sleepless weekend for you, but at the end of a small victory for those who don't think this is the right way for Texas to go. What happens now?
Well, first, I actually want to say I think this was a pretty massive victory. I mean, there was a lot of courage that the House Democrats had to muster up to walk off of the House floor and prevent a quorum right before midnight. But this was the culmination of months and months of on-the-ground organizing, and we have heard everybody from business executives to faith leaders to members of the civil rights community speak out against this bill. And quite frankly, the more that the public hears about it, the less they like it. And so this killed the bill for the regular session. The governor has said he's going to call a special session. We don't know when that's going to be, but I'm also pretty confident that we will be able to kill it again whenever it is brought back.
Well, it does seem as if the fight continues, and it is going in your way a little bit, if reports are to be believed, that at least one provision has already changed from there was a provision that would have pushed voting back to 1 p.m. Sundays, no early votings on Sundays, that a lot of people said would have jeopardized that tradition in so many black churches, the souls to the polls voter turnout push. So now Texas Republicans, I guess they're saying that was just a big misunderstanding, some kind of typo is the claim. Should have read 11 a.m. First, do you think if this is true, the extra time is going to lead to more changes as people get educated about it, as you say?
Absolutely. I mean, we've seen this song and dance the entire legislative session, that every time people start to really look at the bill and question the provisions and the language, that Republicans have been retreating. So one example is there was a huge fight about the fact that this would outlaw souls to the polls, a very popular get out the vote activity with black churches in particular. In the light of day, all of a sudden leading Republicans are saying that it was somehow a typo. But if it was a typo, nobody told the Senate that, because the Texas Senate voted on that exact provision over the weekend. And we saw a similar dynamic play out a couple weeks ago when it was pointed out by civil rights groups and other members of the community that terms like the purity of the ballot, which was in an earlier draft, harken directly to the days of Jim Crow. And that language was removed after that was pointed out. So I actually do anticipate that the more light is shined on this bill, the more that people get into it, we know the more that people don't like it. And we see the Republicans backpedaling quite a bit.
Why are the Republicans so keen on limiting voting hours, on limiting mail-in voting, all that stuff, when there isn't a lot of any evidence in Texas that their votes are insecure?
Well, so first, you are just exactly right. And in fact, the Republican Secretary of State testified under oath that the 2020 election in Texas was smooth and secure. Those were her exact words. And by the way, she was pushed out of office last week, which I think shows you quite a bit about how much this is a Republican priority. Look, I think that what we're seeing in Texas is part of a national trend. We've seen these similar Frankenstein voter restriction laws being passed in Florida, Georgia, and they are directly related to the big lie told about the 2020 election. Another piece of this that sadly we've seen in Texas for years are provisions like those targeting souls to the polls, like those making it more difficult for someone for whom English is not their first language to get the assistance they need to vote. I mean, those provisions are racist and they are targeted at people of color in Texas. And sadly, that is those types of actions we have seen over and over in this state with the deliberate attempt to try to keep certain communities from voting.
And President Biden has been very aggressive recently on bringing this to a national attention. Of course, there are these federal bills, federal action that might address some of the kinds of concerns that people in Texas have about the Republicans' bill and about the Republican Party move across the country. How do you think that will go? First, President Biden did make that case in Tulsa yesterday. How do you think it will go? In Washington, what would it do for people in Texas who are concerned?
Look, this is a national problem, and it deserves a national solution. And I would say all of us should be behind that. I mean, in the 1960s, we saw a groundswell of support for the Voting Rights Act. This is another moment for our country. Our democracy is under deliberate attack. I mean, we've learned, for instance, that conservative shadowy groups have been spending $26 million to make it look like there was a grassroots effort to support restricting voting. It is not true. This is all meant to advance the political agendas of former President Trump and the people aligned with him. And so we cannot stand for this as an American people. And we do need to demand that our lawmakers pass the For the People Act in particular, which is now pending in the U.S. Senate.
And the history of voting in this country is that it did take action, it did take debate, it did take the kind of work that you're doing there to expand the franchise and secure it for all Americans. Mimi Marzianni, president of the Texas Civil Rights Project, thanks for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.